Hello, in this section we'll talk about the Mercury barometer. So the barometer is the simplest application for the hydrostatic formula developed before. So this barometer consists of a reservoir filled with mercury, and we plunge a tube in this reservoir until this tube is completely filled with mercury. There is no more air bubbles, and we invert this tube until the mercury enters this tube and reaches a level equal to H. And above the mercury inside the tube we have a vapor mercury, which has a vapor pressure which is approximately negligible. And let's take now the level of the mercury at the reservoir equal to Z1 and the level of mercury inside the tube equal to Z2. So let's take Z1 equal to 0, and we apply the hydrostatic formula P2 minus P1 equal to minus gamma mercury into Z2 minus Z1. So let's take the two points, P1 as shown and P2. So this is P2, which has the same pressure as the vapor pressure, and P1 below, which lies on the same level of the atmospheric pressure level. So we can say that P1 is equal to P atmosphere, same level, same pressure as we said before, and P2 is equal to P vapor, which is approximately 0. Then the hydrostatic equation will reduce to 0 minus P atmosphere equal to minus gamma. Z2 minus Z1 is simply H. So H will be equal to P atmospheric over gamma mercury. So the atmospheric pressure at sea level will equal to 101,350 Pascal over gamma mercury. Can take gamma mercury as 133,100 newton per meter cube. So we'll obtain a level H equal to 0.761 meter, equivalent to 761 millimeters. Now let's see what happens if we take, for example, water, or we use water instead of mercury. So gamma water is rho water into G. If we take rho water as 1000, so we'll obtain gamma water as 9810 newton per meter cube. So H will be equal to P atmosphere 101,350 Pascal over gamma water 9810. So H will be approximately 13 meters. So this is very impractical as a height. So we need to use a very large tube in order to do this experiment. So that's why we should use a heavy fluid in barometers. So mercury is mainly a heavy fluid that has a very large gamma compared to gamma of water. So that will result in a small level of H compared to the level of H when using water. So we can say that mercury is more suitable to use in the barometer than water.